In the previous pages, 6, 7, and 8, you should have attempted all the exercises, and we will review them in class if you haven't already. You would have found out that some of the problems were not that easy to interpret. Most of the problems you felt shaky on because there was not a systematic approach to answering them. Although it was easy, you make a drawing, you look for the area of interest, and you deduce from all the information what area is under the curve. There were some problems that were, the answers were ambiguous, and those were the star problems I mentioned. Problems with an asterisk. Kind of hard to answer, and in fact, any questions about a normal density curve that were not on the major points 1, 2, or 3 standard deviations away cannot be answered. So we need a more systematic approach to making predictions about outcomes, what to expect from a normal distribution. Okay, so we're going to develop that systematic approach, and it involves using what's called a standard normal density. This is a special normal density curve. Okay, so this curve is so special, it has a special name. It's not going to be referred to as X. Okay, in the last set of problems, you should have answered all the problems using the random variable X with a distribution that's normal with a mean of 64 and a standard deviation of 2. But here, we're going to deal with this Z distribution. Z is distributed, remember that symbol means distributed, normal, with a mean of 0 and a standard deviation of 1. What I'd like you to do in the space below is sketch this distribution. So take a moment and do that, and you can compare with my result. Here's my rendition. This is a normal distribution with a mean of 0 and a standard deviation of 1. So within 1 standard deviation of mean, where the curve goes from concave to convex, are 68% of the observations, so most of the observations. Within 2 standard deviations are 95% of the observations, so that's almost all the observations. And within 3, there are pretty much all the observations at 99.7% of the observations. Okay? So, this is just a normal density. But it's special. Why is it special? Mainly has to do with the dual function of the values that are major tick marks. Okay, so before I would be at the mean. So this is just the mean, and this is 1 standard deviation away, and here is the mean, and this is 1 standard deviation back from the mean. All right. So, whereas before we were using numbers like 64 and 66 and 62, now the number 1 is not just number 1, but it represents 1 standard deviation away. The value minus 1 is not just the value minus 1, it represents minus 1 standard deviation away. So the value itself is telling us where we are relative to the mean. Why is that neat? Well, when looking at the numbers here, 64, we know 64 is the mean, and we know 66 is 1 standard deviation from the mean. But what if I gave you a value like 68.2? Well, I know 64 is the mean. I know 66 is 1 standard deviation from the mean, but I don't know how many standard deviations 68.2 is from the mean. So I can't use my quick rules, you know, I can't do this quickly. I can't establish anything about how many standard deviations away that is, and so I can't say how likely this value is of occurring. Okay, I can estimate it, I can approximate it, right? Because I know 68, that's the next value. I know 68 is the next value. But 68.2, I don't know exactly, precisely, how many standard deviations that is away. But nicely, when I speak about two standard deviations, I know how many standard deviations I am away. When I speak of 2.5 standard deviations, I know how many standard deviations away I am. Okay, so the values on this special density curve not only are values on a density curve, but they're telling me how far they are from the mean. Okay. Similar to the general case of X, a random variable that's normally distributed, we can talk about this being Z. Big Z represents the curve and the area under the curve, okay? And little z, which I'm going to write in script, represents the values along the number line, the continuous number line. Okay, so it looks like kind of a 3, but it's a scripted z to differentiate it from a 2 or from the big z. And so uppercase z for any value, lowercase z for a special value over here. So when I write the p proportion that under the curve big Z that are less than little z, so you can think of this as little z here, and we say the proportion of observations, or the probability that an observation is less than little z, is whatever it is that we're looking for. So that would be the area to the left. So I could draw that as, let's say, this. And I would write, I want to find this area. I already know what it is. So let's write it up. I write probability that big Z is less than 0, and the answer is 50%, or 0.5. And 0 is the mean, it's also the median and the 50th percentile.